Hi everyone, this is Clemmy Games and welcome to the Indie Game Backlog. In this episode, we will take a look at Castle in the Darkness, a retro throwback platformer developed by Matt Kap and released on Steam in February 2016. Castle in the Darkness has you playing as a nameless guard who was on duty when the king fell ill. Without warning, monsters begin to attack, and our hero has to then fend off said monsters. That being said, the plot elements of this game are really light, and this game basically has you exploring a Metroidvania-style open world, killing enemies and bosses along the way. What I enjoyed most about this game is the simplicity of the controls, with movement, attack, and jumping. A little bit into the game, you get the ability to cast spells, and this is done by holding down the attack button to charge up the fireball, which again is pretty much as simple as it gets, with the platforming here feeling really good and really precise. Attacking simply comprises of thrusting your sword out in a rapid fashion, with some enemies taking multiple hits to kill. Also, enemy projectiles can be reflected at them by hitting the projectiles with your sword, and certain enemies even have weak spots which you must hit in order to damage them. There are a fair number of boss fights in this game, the bosses mostly having one or two main attack patterns. While not a tremendous amount of variation in each battle, learning these patterns is critical if you want to defeat each boss. While there are some palette swapped enemies in later sections of the game, there was sufficient variation in that the enemies are altered to a significant degree to make each combat encounter feel different. For example, you have the default skeleton, which simply throws bones at you, but on top of that, the upgraded version does also explode into 3 projectiles when defeated, meaning that the fireball is a better option when tackling this enemy. Defeating enemies and bosses grants you a certain amount of coins, and these can be used to purchase upgrades to your equipment, although upgrades are difficult to come by. In line with this, each upgrade that you do get does feel like a significant upgrade, such as increasing the range of your attack with a longer sword. Defeated bosses also drop a boss heart, which increases your max health as well. Furthermore, there are secret areas to find, each hiding extra loot, as well as side quests to accomplish, such as rescuing the daughter of one of the village NPCs, all of which add to the overall world building of this game. Moving on to an aspect which may not be for everyone, this game is really, really tough. I have died many times in this game, with the game somewhat taunting you with a death screen whenever you die, stating the total number of deaths in the game. While the platforming is precise, it can also be rather unforgiving, especially with the presence of spikes which are an instant kill. Furthermore, while your max health does also increase with each boss defeated, the damage from enemies does also appear to scale up, meaning that you are almost constantly close to death all the time, taking a maximum of 3-4 hits before dying. This punishing difficulty can turn some people off the game, which I do understand, but if you do think back to the old school game design, especially in the original Mario games, those are designed with one-hit kills as well, so that is something interesting to think about and to draw parallels to. Fortunately, Castle in the Darkness does offer save points scattered throughout the game, which not only allows you to save, but does also bring you back to full health. However, these save points may be spread a little too thinly, and frequent deaths coupled with having to go back a couple of screens can quickly become tedious. However, with next to no loading time, I found the experience here to be similar to that of Twitch position platformers such as Super Meat Boy or Phoenix Rage, in that it involved attempting a screen, dying, respawning, and within seconds you are back to where you were. This is certainly a compelling loop, which kept me playing Castle in the Darkness. I've encountered some minor glitches within the game, which is also reflected in a couple of Steam reviews. Personally, I did not come across anything too game-breaking, but rather the most common glitch which I encountered involved the coins that were dropped from enemies somehow phasing into the terrain, so there is a little bit of jank around this game. That being said, nothing too major, so I will overlook this point. Finally, there is something to be said about the overall presentation and look of the game. I really love the pixel art, especially the use of colours, as well as the music in this game. Really fantastic game which evokes many memories of retro games, and I think that this is worth a look if you do enjoy platformers. Anyway, that will do it for this video. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed it, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Leave a comment if you like. Thanks again, and I will see you in the next video.